Thomasina Miers first appeared on our TV screens in 2005 when she was crowned MasterChef champion. Her culinary career has gone from strength to strength, launching her very own Mexican street food eatery, Wahaca, making authentic Mexican food cool in the UK. 14 years on, Thomasina has more than 20 restaurants across the country and has recently been awarded an OBE for her work in the food industry.
I grew up cooking, and also I went to a really academic school where we were supposed to be like prime minister or bankers or lawyers. So I kind of never really occurred to me that it could be a career until much later on, when I just took to it like a duck to water because I realised I was not very good at anything else. So when I was thinking of my greatest dishes, I had to include the ravioli that I cooked on the finals of MasterChef because really it was a pivotal moment in my life. I mean, it changed my life. So it had to go in. So I'm making chicken mousse and hazelnut ravioli with livers, tarragon and thyme. So the first thing I'm going to do is make the filling for the ravioli. I've got lots of lovely fresh thyme and tarragon, which is the herb I love cooking with. It's just got such a lovely flavour. So I worked through my university holidays. I did marketing. I dabbled in fashion. I kind of tried lots of different stuff. I got sacked a few times, made redundant. I saw this advertisement. It was like, do you want to be the next Nigella or Jamie? Which was like a bit embarrassing, not really, but you know, and I did this audition and I got through, which was totally terrifying. And then I'm putting my chicken livers in there too. So mace is obviously a very traditional English spice. Here I've got allspice, which again, it's lovely. It's earthy and sweet and very aromatic. You want this mousse to be quite highly seasoned because there's nothing else going in there that you're not sweating onions or garlic. And then I've got the herbs going in there. You want it to be a lovely smooth mousse. So a splash of brandy in here. And then two egg yolks. There's one. There's the second one. And that is my ravioli filling. I mean, it was literally the most terrifying thing I'd ever done. Your whole soul is on a plate. You know, you're literally cooking with the best of your ability. You're trying so hard that you are exposing everything about you onto that plate of food. And so it's pretty personal and, yeah, it was quite intense. It's just a very simple durum wheat pasta. So the most important thing is to roll it lots to stretch the gluten and get a really nice thin sheet. And that way it's really silky soft. I've stirred in the hazelnuts to my mousse. And there's just a little dollop kind of at intervals. And you can see all the lovely herbs. There we are. And a tiny fleck of quince to bring out that flavour of the chicken liver. Just making this for you today brings back the fear I had when I was making this, the adrenaline. Fold it over. There we are. Throughout the competition, John and Greg had called me this eccentric cook. You know, I'd never eaten in Michelin-starred restaurants before, just not my style of cooking. And I just felt I needed to pull something out of the bag. You know, after the years of stumbling around, failing to find a career, and suddenly I was in this crazy show, but something in me must have known that it was quite important. I remember when Greg tried these, and he was just like, he said, "Quah! Quah, Tommy, quah." And he was like, I remember when he got the hit of quince when he was trying it. It was very gratifying. I didn't even contemplate winning, to be honest. It was so far from my thought. I was just busting a gut to just get the food out right. But I knew I could make people smile with my food. And I guess actually, as long as you're making people smile with the flavour of your food, that is, for me, the most important thing. So now that my ravioli made, I'm gonna get my butter ready. I'm gonna put the ravioli in at the same time. These should take a few minutes. So you can see that the solids are going nutty brown. And I'm going to add the sage. See those lovely colours? And then that lovely toasted sage, which has gone a little bit crispy. And then, of course, oh yeah, finishing it with a squeeze of lemon. A little bit of Parmesan. Tiny bit of olive oil. And a few of those toasted hazelnuts. So there you have it. That is my MasterChef's final ravioli. To think this dish was a turning point in my life. Just think about it now, brings that same old kind of knot in my throat. Because it was like the first time in like a decade where someone was like, do you know what, you're good at this, you can do this. And it's just like, wow, final, like, oh, I can do something in my life. Someone's saying you're good at something, so it was pretty good.